We know that in order to preserve this earth, we have got to reduce the reliance that our energy system has on fossil fuels.
Climate change is real. It's happening here in the UK, it's happening worldwide.
This is absolutely pivotal for the future of the planet. The costs of doing so are clearly enormous.
Both capital and revenue budgets in the public sector are under incredible strain at the moment.
Funding is an issue. You need funding to decarbonise and deliver on your net zero commitments.
The UK has a net zero target of 2050, and to reach that, the public sector plays a key role.
Everybody is aware that this is now a crisis we need to deal with, both for affordability and climate change. We have to do this. It's the right thing to do.
Salix Finance provides support to public sector bodies in England to help them both plan and deliver low carbon and decarbonisation projects.
We are a company that is dedicated to reducing the carbon footprint of the UK. And we're doing it by finding funds through government to help organisations do the right thing for the people of this country.
One of the great things with Salix is that the funding you get is backed by the government. It's a win-win, really.
The Salix funding and its availability has been essential for turning what has often been a largely theoretical exercise into reality.
Most public sector bodies set themselves quite ambitious net zero targets. What we do is help provide the funding and the support to deliver projects that enable them to hit those targets.
It's essential for responding to the climate crisis that we all face.
It's really important we do this as quickly as we can, but it's also really important that if we make public commitments that they are deliverable.
Funding comes from government with various conditions. So what we're trying to do is to match the different funding streams we have available to the needs of whoever is out there that wants to come and talk to us.
The work in England has two streams. The first one is the Low Carbon Skills Fund, which helps public sector bodies identify what the challenges are in their site and their estate and plan ahead for what they need to do. And then the second part is the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme.
The Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme, known as PSDS, is grant funding for the public sector to decarbonise their estate. It's funded by the Department for Energy Security and Net Zero.
The Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme funding has been a fantastic opportunity to carry out the decarbonisation work necessary and support the good work that we're all trying to push on with.
The Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme has enabled us, it enables anybody else that wants to apply and get in grant funding to accelerate the speed and the pace at which we get decarbonisation to happen.
For us, this is both inspirational and transformational, which you don't often say about government. Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme is absolutely necessary.
If you're interested in accessing the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme grant funding, start by understanding what it is you have on your estate.
We've been through a couple of application processes. There's a lot of helpful guidance before that that you can take part in. There's some lots of webinars, there's lots of information that's available on the website. Or just talking to other people that have been through the process.
You need to identify what sort of measures you'd like to implement at your site, what it's going to cost, what is the expected savings. You'll then need to input that into the Salix application form.
It's been really positive with Salix is we're talking to people that understand what we're trying to do. They understand the technical of what we're trying to do and they understand the process of how we're trying to fund construction and contracting. You're talking to somebody about a heat pump, they know what you're talking about, you know, on the other end of it, which is very rare.
We want to help guide you so that you're able to deliver on time and within the scope that is required by the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme.
Wolfson College is a graduate college. It's about 60 years old. It's packed with international students. And we cover all of the different disciplines at Oxford. So we've got scientists, we've got lawyers, we've got artists. The whole range. When it was built in the early 70s, nobody had heard of climate change, nobody had heard of carbon emissions. So it was built with big windows, with very, very poor insulation. We've realised we're the worst emitter of all the Oxford colleges. The college for many years has acted in a way that has been as green as it can be, But we set ourselves the target of by 2030 reducing our emissions to zero. We had a proper look at how to bring us down to net zero. The technologists, the engineers told us how to do it, and the challenge then was making it happen.
This is Wolfson College. We've replaced all the windows, massively reduced the demand for heat, and we've electrified the residual demand for heat with electric heat pumps. Having someone to look at an estate and how they use energy is an important first step. So we thought about how to reduce their energy demands, but also, critically in our view, get them off of fossil fuels, get fossil fuels out of the buildings and put them on a pathway to be part of a net zero carbon society.
We did a proper study of what it would take to bring us down to net zero. The cost at that stage were something like £10 million. That was an impossible sum for us. We heard from Salix that there were opportunities to get government funding to help us. So we put in our application to Salix. We did get the money, £5 million at first, on the basis that we would then go out and find others to help supplement that sum. The bulk of it was insulation works, so that was turning single pane windows into triple glazing.
All the windows we can see here have been replaced. The heat loss for all of those windows has been reduced by sort of 80% or so.
It was ensuring the roofs of our buildings were properly insulated. We then could shift to turning off our gas boilers and replacing them with the latest air source heat pumps.
Right now we're in the plant room. Two big heat pumps, and they do the space heating and the hot water of the college. It's enabled the legacy gas boilers to be turned off, and they have been replaced by 700 kilowatts of new air source heat pump. A lot less gas is being burnt. The carbon savings of the project over the next 20 years, we expect to be on the order of 20,000 tonnes.
Our relationship with Salix has been a very strong and good relationship. We could not have found that £10 million without the funding that came from Salix. It gave us the confidence that we could do the funding, but it also gave us the incentive to go and find the rest of the money, which we wouldn't otherwise have had. So it's been a real partnership between our own reserves, Salix, and donors that has allowed the project to happen. And what I have found at Wolfson is that this has not simply been a building project. This has been a transformation of the way the whole community of the college works and works together in a way that wouldn't have been possible without the trials, but also the successes of this programme.
The University of West London is based, as the name would suggest, in West London. We have our Ealing campus. We also have a campus down in Brentford, which covers particularly our nursing activities. We also have then a satellite nursing campus out in Reading. We're covering a fairly decent patch in the southeast of England.
The University of West London is committed to being net zero carbon by 2030. So that's 20 years earlier than the government requires us to be. Sustainability is undoubtedly a priority for the university.
Our priority is firstly on reduction, so reduce as much emissions as possible. And then our other priority was change the mix of our energy sources by way of increasing renewable and clean energy sources.
Salix funding, the way that it's structured, made it that funding was no longer a barrier to the project. The only barriers would have been a will to do it.
As part of the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme, we secured £5 million worth of investment, and we used that to decarbonise four of our main sites in West London.
The majority of the funding went towards installing very large-scale ground source heat pump in our main campus in Ealing, West London. We installed a 900 kilowatt system, which is fairly big.
We had 34 boreholes drilled within a very tight urban landlocked site, so it's quite challenging in terms of logistics and designing something that could come up.
This whole entire area was completely turfed, and to install the pumps, these boreholes were being drilled 170 metres down in the ground. It enabled us to reduce our gas consumption at that site by 92%, which is quite impressive and an important step towards decarbonisation.
We're now on top of the roof on our main campus in St Mary's Road. What you'll see behind me is our solar photovoltaic thermal systems. We've got over 580. We designed this in such a way that we've maximised as much roof space as possible. So every inch of our roof, where possible, has been filled with these solar photovoltaic thermal system.
We've now got an array that delivers all of our heating and hot water on the site at St Mary's Road. As a combined system with the ground source heat pump, it has been labelled the world's largest of its kind.
We certainly found that the relationship on multiple projects we've now had with Salix has been good, strong, open, and that was critical for us.
The project was really successful for us and it has been positive in every light. In total, per year, the systems will save 529 tonnes of carbon emissions, which is a huge step towards our carbon reduction target.
We're on a journey. We're at a phase where we're trying to change culture. How do we get people to change their habits, work and operate in a different way? Those wider changes that will take some time to bed in, but actually I think will have the longer term sustainable impact.
At Birmingham Women's and Children's Foundation Trust, we have a children's hospital and a women's hospital. From a targets point of view, we are mandated by NHS England to be carbon zero by 2040 for some of our carbon, and for 2045 by the remainder of our carbon. We're quite passionate about that. Funding and the challenge around funding is huge for any NHS organisation, any public sector organisation in fact. The start of our decarbonisation programme hugely accelerated in fact through this funding through Salix.
The opportunity to really look at sustainability and look at investment into our estate was a real positive for us because it took it to the side of the normal capital threshold that we have.
In PSDS 3A, we secured £53 million worth of funding across two of our sites, two different applications, and in 3B, we secured another £10 million. The support's been great. We have regular catch-ups with various people, whether that's commercial aspects or technical aspects, or just transferring information between one organisation and another. 3A programme, at both sites are removing our fossil fuel heating systems, and we're replacing those with ground source heat pumps. So we're drilling holes down into the ground for about 200 metres, pulling out the water from the ground, taking the heat from that, using that heat in our systems, and then putting the water back in the ground again.
We're currently drilling 6 boreholes at the children's site, and we've got 2 on the children's site pre-drilled, and they've tested and they've come back great. The real aim of that is to create as much surface area underneath where you're moving water from and to so you don't affect it. And also you get a much bigger separation in temperature as well between them two spaces.
This will remove somewhere in the order of 8,000 tonnes of carbon from our portfolio of carbon.
We put hoarding up around the works to sort of infuse the children at the hospital and get them engaged, because some children that we've got are here for quite a long time, you know, they can be in and out the hospital and they'll see the progress of that. So really we wanted to relate that as a childlike sort of philosophy. But what we also wanted to do is create as an educational piece for the wider NHS estates and the public sector, so people can come and see what we're doing.
Our women's hospital is a terrible building. It has very thin walls, single glazing. Whilst it's a great decarbonisation story, it's also a great story for our patients, in that once we've re-insulated and re-glazed that building, it'll look a lot nicer, but also it'll be a lot nicer inside those buildings for our patients too.
It's a real textbook case of opportunity of change the windows, change the exterior wall, lock that heat in, lock that cooling in, which means in total we'll need a lot less of both.
Projects like these, they don't come around very often. For us as a trust, it's changing the way that we operate, it's changing the experience that our staff and the patients have in our facilities. But of course, we are hopefully reducing enough carbon to make a difference to the planet in the future.
Cheshire East is a rural borough, pleasant place to work and live. The climate emergency was declared not long ago. Cheshire East Council has responded to that emergency by bringing forward its carbon neutral targets for our operational buildings. And we also have a borough-wide target of carbon neutral by 2045, which includes our schools. Initially, the biggest challenge for us was identifying those opportunities, those projects. Certainly, if we want the grant funding, it's got to meet the eligibility criteria. We overcame that by working closely with our FM partners, Equans. We pulled together all our knowledge, resources, our understanding of the buildings, the building fabric, the lighting controls.
When we're reviewing the buildings, we find a mixture of issues and opportunities. We often take a building fabric approach first. So we're looking at the age of the roof, how efficient the roof and the building fabric is, and then we'll be looking at the heating assets and can we make that more efficient.
Thankfully, we were successful in obtaining funding across four rounds of PSDS money. Salix talked us through the whole process, any kind of concerns we had, they offered guidance, so that was really useful.
The constraint comes from finding the procurement route once the grant's in place. I'm proud that Cheshire's actually took the time to plan the procurement route as part of the design stage, allowing us to get straight onto delivery once they were successful with the grant.
Heat decarbonisation is the big challenge. The electrification of heating, that's the route that we're taking. We have completed three air source heat pump installations in the process of commissioning a further 11. Solar PV installations, we've completed 19 from Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme grants. The total capacity is around 1.6 megawatts. Oh, we're at Jordan Gate Multi-Story Car Park. We have solar PV installation. We've got a shy of 500 modules, so we're powering just the shy of 200 kilowatts. So that's going to provide a huge amount of power. Some of it will be used for the car park, some of it will be used to power our EV chargers, and the rest will be surplus to the grid. The adult daycare centre, which is the Readsmere Centre, caters for the needs of vulnerable adults who are in need of help and attention. We've done multiple projects at this centre. First of all, we've done the air source heat pump installation, displacing gas use. On top of that, we had to upgrade the insulation levels to minimise the heat loss. We've installed solar PV to reduce the electricity load, and also LED lighting, we've upgraded that. These centres are an important part of the community. Adults who are in need these places open, and they get the care that they need. So these services are vital for the community. Our carbon savings from all the projects that we've completed under the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme grants, we're estimating the equivalent of 900 tonnes of CO2 savings per annum. It's a climate emergency, we need to act. Projects will get us some way, but more importantly, it's a behavioural change that's needed.
So Greater Manchester Combined Authority is the hub. We support the 10 local authorities of Greater Manchester. We cover everything from skills and workforce, digital enablement, low carbon environment, growth, economy, policy, but our role is to support.
We are here to guide our local authorities on how to decarbonise their estate.
We set a target of 2038 for carbon neutrality, and this meant that we would be a decade faster, earlier than the UK. That is extremely challenging. It's possible, but challenging. So how much would it cost us to get to 2038? Within the public sector, probably 10 to 12 billion pounds. We do not have 12 billion pounds.
Through the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme, that has enabled us to secure just over 110 million in grant funding with match funding to help deliver these schemes, and that has rapidly accelerated our progress towards these targets. The working relationship with Salix was very collaborative. I really saw them as a critical friend, making sure that we were understanding what the requirements were and proactively building that into the programme and responding to that. We've got a client relationship manager, so they help advise us, guide us and keep us on track.
Under PSDS 1, we secured 78 million of capital funding, and from that, about 53 million was spent on four key measures: heating, primarily solar PV, LED, and insulation.
I think in total, that's helped us to achieve £2 million worth of revenue savings across the estate, but also 15% contribution towards our renewable energy generation target.
My name's Dr. Ruth Ande, and I work for Manchester City Council as a zero carbon project manager. I'm here right now at the Manchester Aquatic Centre. So initially the building opened in 2002 for the Commonwealth Games, but actually we're doing a massive project as the council to decarbonise the building and also a huge regeneration of the building. We fitted air source heat pumps to reduce energy consumed for heating the building and the swimming pools that you see behind me. We've also fitted solar panels on the roof. Salix have funded the air source heat pumps, the solar panels, and also some of the building management systems that we're going to be installing. We've been funded to the value of, I think, £2.3 million, which is just a huge enabler to allow us to do this kind of work. It's going to have a really big impact on reducing the carbon that this building consumes, because obviously swimming pools, to keep them warm, use a huge amount of heating. So the works that we're doing are going to really reduce the carbon impact on the city.
Salix funding has made a great difference to Rochdale Council, part of the Greater Manchester Combined Authority. In total, for the Rochdale Council, we got just short of £11 million. So this is Middleton Arena. It's a swimming pool, gymnasium. In the auditorium, they have shows, plays. It's very important for the community. It brings everybody in together. We've had air source heat pumps put in, replaced the gas boilers. We've had LED lighting, solar panels put on the roof, the new airlock on the front doors.
It's been a really exciting journey over the past couple of years. To think about the level of investment that we've managed to secure has been incredible.
If we can show leadership by investing in our own buildings, it provides community hubs, it provides future services for residents, then it's also the economic impact and are we providing and supporting local jobs, skills and then wider economy.
Seeing everyone come together to share the lessons, to help each other along, I think it's put us in a really strong position to now achieve the targets that Greater Manchester has set itself.
The City of London Corporation is a unique organisation. It is the oldest continually elected surviving democracy in the world. It is the local authority for the square mile, so we are the government of the square mile, responsible for all the planning and licensing and housing, etc. But we are also the organisation that promotes the interests of the financial and insurance and professional services sector, both in the UK and internationally. We have made a very, very important public commitment to get our Scope 1 and 2 emissions, are the things that we directly control, our own operations, to net zero by 2027. That is our absolute focus right now. And I insisted that it had three attributes. One, it was deliverable. Two, it was impactful. And three, that it was funded.
When we first contacted Salix, we had a number of queries about the scheme being a new scheme and the eligibility and technologies and so forth. And they were really helpful, very responsive. We were assigned a single liaison point at Salix, which is immensely helpful that you've got a single person to go to.
The Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme, this particular grant, has enabled us to focus on heating, ventilation, lighting and cooling. We had a grant of £9.5 million, all fully invested. The projects have all been completed hugely successfully.
Our projects funded through the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme focused on some of our largest and most carbon intensive sites. A lot of the spaces are open to the public. For example, at the Barbican Centre, where we have over 1 million visitors per year. It's extremely important that for these events that visitors are enjoying their experience, and part of that is ensuring a comfortable environment. We're standing in the Barbican Concert Hall, and the PSDS project, it involved upgrading the ventilation fans so they were running as efficiently as possible and making modifications to the heating and cooling system so they were supplying just the right level of energy. Having a comfortable environment is really important for people who are attending the event so that they enjoy the experience. We're standing in the main plan room for the Barbican Arts Centre. In the PSDS project, a lot of works were carried out in this plant room. As well as improving the efficiency of the plant, we've also upgraded the ability for us to control and manage the supply of the energy throughout the centre. We're in the Guildhall Art Gallery, which contains over 4,000 paintings and other works of art which the City of London Corporation have been collecting since the 17th century. And it's really important that the environments they're displayed in and stored is closely controlled in terms of temperature and humidity. So the art gallery was a real priority for us to access the Salix funded PSDS scheme so that we could implement upgrades to the ventilation system. And that included replacement fans, humidification controls, and heat recovery. I feel the projects have been really successful. We project we'll be achieving 1,300 tonnes a year of carbon savings.
which we have calculated will save us £1 million a year in energy costs. We've proved that these funds can be invested and applied in a very focused way to particular buildings, and in our case some of them are quite challenging, particularly we have listed buildings. We are holding ourselves to account publicly every year for delivery against that strategy. We have a climate action dashboard on the City of London Corporation's website. Anybody can go and see at a granular level where we are on each of our sets of actions to get to the net zero targets. This funding has enabled us to accelerate our plans and to do things more quickly.
Leeds Teaching Hospitals is probably one of the largest, most complex estate portfolios across the NHS. We have just over 520,000 square metres of estate spanning the whole of Leeds and six individual sites.
The NHS has set its target as 2040 to achieve net zero. For the Trust to comply with that, we have to really look at what we've got across our estates and understand our sites and the detail behind them.
We want to be one of the greenest trusts in the NHS. We're on target to meet our net zero challenge by 2040. We're really fortunate because we've got buy-in from ward to board in terms of sustainability, and our estates and facilities teams are really passionate about making our sites more efficiently in terms of carbon reduction.
Complexity of the estate, we've everything from Victorian listed property right through to modern constructed built properties, providing all mixed range of different services. Being able to adapt and modernise the old infrastructure takes a lot of planning and also a lot of financing as well. Funding is a challenge. We have a limited capital budget.
We've managed to secure over £22 million with the help of PSDS, so some real complex large schemes across the whole of Leeds. Funding streams like this really help us accelerate our plan. So we have a green plan in place. We've just done a lot of work on decarbonisation and better understanding that granular detail for each site.
We've done a number of fabric upgrades across our estate, upgrading single glazing to double glazing. It's also been around flat roofs and replacing them and improving insulation. The majority of our sites are reliant on fossil fuels. We are reliant on steam infrastructure, particularly at St James. Moving away from the steam infrastructure and doing that in a staged approach is really what the challenge is, particularly for this site. This is the Energy Centre at the St James University Hospital site, and what we're seeing now as part of PSDS 3A is 11 new plant rooms for various buildings across the estate being added onto this low carbon network to replace the existing steam infrastructure. It was really up against the clock in terms of the time pressures, but we managed to get it delivered. The installation's a really good standard, and we're looking forward to getting the carbon savings and benefits from the works. And one of our large wings, Beckett Wing, that was connected up to Leeds pipes in PSDS 1, which disconnected the steam infrastructure from that building, reducing our reliance on fossil fuels and having a lower carbon alternative to supply that building, which is a 24/7 clinical building. We also looked at heat pumps onto site as well. It was an air and water source heat pump, which was installed on the CHP circuit.
Salix have been fantastic throughout. Without this funding, we wouldn't have been able to accelerate our green plan to the pace that we're doing right now. They've been very supportive on the technical data, helping us prepare some of the cases, and then throughout the schemes as well.
We are seeing significant decrease in carbon. I think from the two projects combined, we're looking at about 5,500 tonnes of carbon savings per year.
So I suppose it's been a large anchor institution across Leeds. We've got a real big role to play across the city.
And I think being able to celebrate that within the city now and show people that, you know, we are taking this seriously and our actions really show that.
So our ambition as a trust is not only to meet net zero by 2040, but to exceed that target if at all possible. And with funding streams like this, it feels more possible than it's ever been.
Lancaster's quite a diverse district, city, coast and countryside. A really lovely place to live and work. The council's working towards a net zero target by 2030. Unsurprisingly, a good chunk of the council's emissions come from natural gas associated with heating our buildings. Funding is always a challenge, certainly for big, you know, significant projects like the ones we've been working on. The PSDS Phase 1 was announced. We recognised that that was a fantastic opportunity for us, so we worked quickly to submit an application. And we found out in February 2021 that we were successful. Right, so here we are at Salter Leisure Centre, one of Lancaster City Council's flagship facilities, and now a completely decarbonised leisure centre thanks to Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme funding. We're running completely now on renewable energy. And Salter is a really popular facility. We've got a swimming pool, we've got a gym, we've got a large cafe, we've got soft play, we've got climbing walls. We were awarded £6.8 million altogether to decarbonise Salter Leisure Centre. We took quite a holistic approach. We were keen to ensure that we improved building fabric, so we replaced all the glazing on site with more thermally efficient glazing. We installed LED lighting throughout. We replaced our gas heating system with a two-stage heat pump system. So we've got two PowerMaster air source heat pumps. These connect all the way through to the plant room where we've got our water to water heat pumps to give us the temperature that we need throughout the leisure centre. We're completely off gas at Salter, so this is the only heating source for Salter Leisure Centre. And then we also built a 1.3 megawatt solar farm on a nearby landfill site and connected that to the site with a direct wire. We're here on the football pitch next to the landfill site at Salter, where we've installed 2,880 450 watt Longi modules. This will produce roughly about 1.1 million kilowatt hours of electricity for the centre, which will provide about 30% of the annual needs for the centre. The rest will be coming from a green energy RIGO-backed tariff. And during the spring and summer months, that scene is kind of off-grid completely for up to 12 hours a day. It is a visible site. You can see it from the football pitch and from other areas around the centre. It's a really good use of a piece of land that you couldn't ordinarily do a great deal with. You can't build on these landfill sites, especially when there's a landfill cap. So renewable energy, solar PV, is a really good option for them. Working with Salix has been great. The webinars were incredibly helpful. The guidance information that came out was useful. The impact that the project has had has been pretty significant. The CO2 savings that we've managed to achieve are around 640 tonnes a year. We were awarded the Best Decarbonisation Initiative of 2022 from APSE, which is the Association for Public Service Excellence. Oh, it's been a fantastic opportunity to deliver such a key project for Lancaster. And I think as far as we're aware, this is the first carbon neutral leisure centre in the UK, certainly the first to be completely off gas. So yeah, it's a landmark project for us and something that I'm certainly really proud of.
The Royal Latin School sits right in the heart of Buckingham. Our school has around 1,300 students, just over. Royal Latin School, we're absolutely passionate about sustainability and about looking after the environment in the most general sense. We've got a series of pledges that say, well, what can we do during this year and beyond to actually make the world a better place?
The buildings here are quite a varied age, some old, some new, which gives us all sorts of problems. We have had issues with insulation, windows, heating.
So we heard about the Public Sector Decarbonisation Scheme. Salix were terrific in coming back really quickly, and actually the process from there on became fairly straightforward.
So the grant we received was just over £282,000, which made a massive impact on how we progressed our installation of the systems we required. We had a very aged set of gas boilers.
And originally we were thinking of a gas-fired traditional solution. But because of Salix, we were able to look at alternatives.
That changed to air source heat pumps, which has really, really paid dividends for us as a school.
These are our two air source heat pumps. They're installed as part of the PFBS project. They run the heating and hot water in the Brookfield House part of the school. So we've got a Trend BMS system that runs it. We have a constant supply of hot water, and our heating is so much more efficient from this.
We were also able to install solar panels in one of the main teaching blocks of the school. We're also able to store some of that. Part of the grant was that we've got batteries so that when we're overproducing, as it were, we're able to store some of that energy as well. We have replaced all of the windows and all of the doors in the oldest part of the building, and it's made a huge difference.
The impact of the project was huge because prior to this we had staff sitting in offices in coats in the winter, but now it's a really comfortable working environment.
From a student point of view, I think what surprised some of our students is the scale of the project that we've been able to put in place.
We have a strong group of students who are really interested in environmental issues. They form themselves into a group that they call Green Touch.
They see the changes we're making and the improvements we're making, and it makes it for a great place for them to learn.
We've seen this project now from start to finish, and I'm really proud of what we've been able to achieve. What we have in place now is making a massive difference to our school, but it wouldn't have been there without Salix.
For prospective applicants interested in getting Salix funding, on the website you have a lot of information there. You can see what the criteria is for the application.
The Salix website is a fantastic resource to visit, to have a look at case studies, to look at what other organisations have done.
And we are connecting people together so that there's that learning in the industry from what others have done.
There are a lot of stories to be shared when it comes to project delivery, and what we like to be able to support clients with is sharing that knowledge that we've gained from other projects.
If you can access funding which demonstrates continued investment in the estate, continued improvement, you can use that to show your staff that you really care about your site and at the same time deliver sustainability targets. Why wouldn't an organisation do it?
Do engage with Salix. Come forward with other ideas. There's a lot of opportunity working in partnership that can allow you to perhaps do things you haven't even thought about.
This is not simply about preserving buildings and maintaining buildings. This is about preserving the planet and preserving the future generations. It's extraordinary that we can get the kind of support from Salix and from the government that allows to do this really transformational work for us, but inspirational for everybody else facing the same challenges over the next 10, 20 years.